Tack så mycket.
Och vi ska ju säga till dig som lyssnar, vi kommer att göra den här intervjun delvis, ja, ganska mycket på engelska eftersom Terry, you're from Britain.
That's correct.
Yeah. So what do you do in Avesta tonight?
Tonight we're going to have what you, in English or Swedish you call it a stor seance, but in English it would be known as a clairvoyant demonstration.
Could you guide us through what is it actually that you're going to perform in Avesta tonight?
Well, tonight, in front of 400 people, what I will actually do is I open up, which in simple terms means I find the level or the frequency of spirit, the spirit world. So I open up and then I wait to see if anyone will come and contact me. Normally, the contact can work in different ways. It will either guide me directly to the person sitting in the audience, or it will give me some idea of the location of where they're sitting. Sometimes they can use names, they can use lots of different techniques. So once I have found the person that they, the contact, wishes to speak to, then I just pass on the information that I receive from the spirit contact.
It's the spirits who contact you and not the people in the audience asking you to.
No, a lot of people think that I can just pick up a telephone line and ask for anybody to come, and that's never been my experience. And in all the years I've been working with this, and I actually started working with this or learning about this when I was 22 years old.
Det är som sagt en stor seans i Avesta, och då är det så att Terry, när han väl ställer sig på scenen, det är ju inte som kanske många tror att det är publiken som har fått tag i Terry och undrar, kan du inte kontakta den här och den här personen i min närhet som har gått bort, utan det är ju då the spirits, andarna.
They decide. I just open up. It's like turning on a radio. I'm a receiver, transmitter. And I just pass on the information that's given to me.
Terry säger att det är ungefär som att slå på en knapp. Typ till en radio. Att man är både sändare och mottagare av signaler från andevärlden. Terry, how do you do that? Could you do that right now if I ask you? Or is it a hard process doing that?
Well, no.
Does it take energy from you?
Well, when I open up and I use as a channel, the energy is also given to me by the spirit world, but it is hard work because I have to focus 100%.
Are you tired after a show like in Avesta tonight? Exhausted?
Let's not call it a show. 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 Let's call it a demonstration. yeah, I'm tired, but the more you work with it, the more you get used to it.
Terry säger alltså att man liksom, att öppna upp sig för andevärlden, det tar en del energi och man blir lite trött av att göra det. How does it feel? Jag ska fråga Terry här hur det känns att ha den här gåvan, eller vad man ska kalla det. How does it feel to be able to do this?
For me, quite normal, quite natural.
So it's never painful? You never wake up in the morning thinking, oh, it would be nice to not be a medium today?
I've had a few occasions when I've thought, you know, why am I doing this? Sure. And I think it's always very important from a morale perspective, to think, you know, to question yourself sometimes. I think it's very easy to fall into a way of working where you stop thinking, and when you stop thinking then you're in trouble, when you take things for granted.
Terry säger här alltså att han har aldrig liksom ångrat att han gett sig in på den här banan, men han har samtidigt ibland känt att ska jag verkligen göra det här, det är ett stort moraliskt ansvar och så vidare att vara ett medium. Terry, how important is the breakthrough in Det Okända for you personally? You've been in this TV show, The Okända.
Well, you mean from professionally or whatever?
Yeah.
On a personal level, it's been a great challenge because it's enabled me to develop my gift even more. And it's given me the confidence, you know, there have been times, and I can't mention their names, that I've actually helped the police. You know, there have been times, and I can't mention their names, that I've actually helped the police. You know, there have been times, and I can't mention their names, that I've actually helped the police.
And on a professional level?
You mean financially?
Yeah.
Oh, I wondered where it was coming to that. Well, of course, it's made me more become a public figure. And once you're a public figure, then that opens a door where it is almost, can be likened to a tsunami. But on a professional level, of course, it has my name has spread and become more popular. I employ 6 people because when we have this Kursgård, when people come to for me for courses, it's full pension. They get full board lodging. There's a course, and in between the courses, they get a lot of backup with the work they have to do. So
Mm. Så Terry säger alltså att genombrottet, vad ska man säga, eller tv-tiden han har fått med Det okända har gjort honom dels, alltså det har utvecklat honom på ett personligt plan, att han har liksom fått utmaningar i och med det programmet som han hävdar att han har lyckats klara, och också sen så har det inneburit en del, vad ska man säga, finansiella intäkter. Du har 6 stycken anställda i ditt företag.
Yes. Yeah. Mm.
Och du har drivit en kursgård också.
Yes.
What do you say to people that don't believe in what you do?
When I work as a media, I mean, I'm just a neutral channel, you know. I believe in it. For me, it works. I've had proof again and again and again on many different levels. But people that don't believe in what I do, that's okay. I'm not. My job or my mission isn't to convert people, manipulate people, or to believe in what I believe. Because it's everybody's human right to believe in what they want to believe in. Because we all have our own unique truth, and as long as it doesn't break the law or doesn't psychologically harm people.
But like a demonstration tonight in Avesta, it's sold out. Roughly, how much would you earn on a night like this?
Well, I just get my regular salary each month. That's as simple as that. Mm. And that's there for anyone that wants to check it out. Everything goes back to the company.
Det är så att han inte lever något extraordinärt eller extravagant liv, i varje fall inte så här materiellt sett eller så.
Nej, precis. Det är ju en utsåld föreställning ikväll. Och Terry menar att det blir inte jättemycket pengar över till honom. Det är inga fina restauranger och ingen fin bil, utan han är som han är och lever ett stillsamt liv.
But I'm thinking about the moral responsibility again, because often you, I wouldn't say help, but you get questions from people who wants you to get in touch with their dead relatives. They could be dead children or whatever. Mm-hmm. And I mean, that's a huge moral responsibility. What if you do wrong? What if you get the wrong info from the spirits? I mean, how could you live with that?
Well, let's just say it like this, and I'll give this question back to you. How often do you make mistakes? How often do you get everything right? Nobody does.
No, I mean, quite a few times.
But it's a different moral responsibility.
It is, yeah. So I'm going to tell you what I've done. I realized very early on the moral responsibility of doing this, so I did one very important thing. I went to have some therapy. I wanted to be able to identify when that baggage was coming up to the surface when I'm working, so I can set a line. And that's worked pretty well. Yes, of course, sometimes you can make mistakes. But there's this, again, this misconception that everybody that goes to a medium is there just because of grief. That is not true.
Terry säger att det är ett missförstånd att det skulle vara folk som är i sorg eller som har förlorat någon som kommer, utan att det kan vara folk som kommer av nyfikenhet då. Men jag är lite nyfiken på det just. Okay. I'm a bit curious about that curiosity, because do you think like nowadays when religion is not that
spread out
in the society, like this is a new kind of religion, this new age thing, is this like a new religion for people? Do they believe more in this than in
move away from the word religion. It's not a religion. I think we've come to, it's an interesting question you've asked, because I think we've come to a time now where established religion as we've known it is changing. You can see that. And I think the consciousness of everyday people now, you know, the old religions can't answer all the questions. And as I said to you earlier on in the interview, people are looking for questions. They want to know what their truth is. They want to find their way of believing that there is a God or a higher intelligence.
Terry säger här alltså att det här skulle kunna vara en form av en ny sorts religion, att man i varje fall överger tron på de gamla religionerna för att hitta andra svar än vad...
Men samtidigt är ju tydlig med att det handlar inte om religion det här, utan det här är någonting som man har hållit på med i urminnes tider. Man vill inte bli ihopkopplad med religion.
No. So, what's up next for you? A few hours to the demonstration in Avesta.
How
do you prepare?
Well, once we leave here, I'll go and eat some lunch. We'll drive slowly to Avesta, and then we will go and buy some flowers for the table on the scene. And we'll just relax and get ready, set things up, and get ready the sound technicians and stuff. And then when the guests come. When people come to a public demonstration, it's an intimate thing. It's private to them. You know, and not everybody that come want the whole world to know that they're there.
But so, at the same time, I mean, you need to be published. You need to, get the word out.
that I do all the time, every day I work. You know, it's I've never been one that's looked for a lot of publicity. It's not, I don't need that. My ego doesn't need that. It was really interesting that Afton Blodet wrote a pretty critical article on me some years ago, and then some months later they asked me to work for them. And I can tell you this, they really checked my credibility out as to whether or not I could do this. I did a ghostbusting for them where I had a journalist follow me and check it all out. That was correct. And how can I fool or trick someone like Afton Blodet? Impossible. Because they have quite a reputation.
Oh, well, I'm not sure. They have a reputation of being like a newspaper, and like a tabloid.
Well, okay, you can use tabloids, well, but at the end of the day, they're not going to look...
Well, they're not Svenska Akademin, Terry.
Yeah, but why? Okay, they're not, but does the academic mind always understand everything? Can't an academic mind also be a very narrow mind? You know, if this whole world was just based on academic results, wouldn't it be an empty, cold world?
Okay, thank you, Terry Evans, for coming here. And good luck? You don't say good luck because... Do you need luck in contact with the spirits?
Well, I think everybody needs a little luck sometimes.
Okay. Okay, then good luck with the demonstration tonight in Avesta.
Again, thank you for the
interview. Yes, thank you for coming.
Okay, it's been interesting. Thank you.